and with your Spirit.
And let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess to Almighty
God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. All you peoples, clap your hands. Shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpet blasts. Sing praise to God, sing praise to our King, sing praise. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. For King of all the earth is God, sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations, God sits upon his holy throne. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory and his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him in his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him his head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We used to celebrate Ascension Thursday. We still celebrate Ascension, but for Diocese of Ohio, it's changed to following Sunday. When you come into the gathering area of the church, you look to your left, you see a beautiful three-paneled depiction in glass of the Ascension of Jesus. The Ascension means that he went up. We speak about this other world that is up. We talk about going up to heaven. But we note that Jesus disappeared behind a cloud. The cloud means the realm of mystery. Some of you might remember the famous comment of the Soviet cosmonaut who went up into space, and he came down and he was more convinced than ever that God didn't exist because he didn't see him. Well, let me tell you, I think most people understand that heaven is really not a place. I mean, it's not spatial. You can never locate it. We develop a spaceship that can go to the farthest reaches of space and never find heaven, because that's not what it's about. Jesus did go up, but that was an ascent to a mysterious realm, which we hope one day to cross this frontier. The borderline, of course, is death. One
must die in order to see God. And of course, dying in his good time. The life we have now is a gift we must cherish. But life has a goal. St. Paul talked about the finish line, that he was not shadow boxing or practicing. He was taking life very seriously, as an athlete takes seriously, running toward the finish line. So we have to keep in mind where we're going, where we hope to be going. Our society has marginalized God. I was talking with a policeman the other day who's off duty. He said he almost got in trouble with his superior because after some sort of routine traffic stop, he said to a woman, "May God bless you." The woman was pretty upset about it. He didn't do it to upset her. She was a complete stranger. So she reported it to the superior. And the superior, very sensible man, said, "Ma'am, that's your problem. That's your problem." Which indeed it is. Lack of faith or embracing the truths of God is a problem. Because heaven is where God is. So what do we mean when we say, "Our Father who art in heaven"? We don't mean that God is far, far away. What we mean is that God is majestic. And we hope to be with him one day in a complete way. But heaven really begins here. Because God dwells within hearts of people who are in a state of grace. He dwells there not as a stranger, but as a friend. When St. Therese made her first communion, now keep in mind, she was very mature for her in her understanding. She said, "A piece of heaven came into me." Isn't that true? We received the Lord, a piece of heaven is coming into us. Heaven begins here. But this is not, obviously, everything it's supposed to be. This world is not heaven. One of the places I visited on a pilgrimage to Europe some years ago was Auschwitz, which is the death camp in Poland. Now, even in the darkest places, the glimmer of the light of heaven can shine. In this particular case, it's shown in the prisoner in cell number 18. Who was the prisoner in cell number 18 in Auschwitz? It's a Franciscan priest named Maximilian Kolbe, who is now a canonized saint. He died so that another man might live. He allowed himself to be injected, poisoned, in place of another man who had a family. Maximilian used his time in this terrible place to encourage other people to hold on to their faith. He led people singing hymns. He refused to respond in kind to the sadistic guards. But the only explanation for men like Maximilian Kolbe was that God was in him. And he died giving his life completely to God. There are many stories. Heaven begins here, it doesn't end here. In fact, this is only the beginning. The person is in a state of grace and is experiencing fruits of the Holy Spirit, which are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, mildness, chastity, so forth. Person is receiving it, has received the down payment of the heavenly life. But in this life, there's always a danger of losing something. There are many tears that people shed for good reason. There are many injustices. And no one's salvation is completely sewn up. Unlike fundamentalists who say if you meet Jesus, that's all you need. If your salvation is assured, it's not assured. Every day must be a day for turning our hearts over to God. We don't do it just once. Being a holy person requires daily effort. But people can grow in holiness. But why would someone grow in holiness if he doesn't really believe there's anything to it? If people are more interested in getting ahead in this world, and if they've given themselves too much to the world, and it's all of its false promises, what the people are doing is compromising their calling. The calling that we have as Christians is to live with God here and after death. If a person doesn't live with God after death, it means he's in hell. And hell is hell because the person has died such that he's rejected God up until the last minute. Doesn't want it. God doesn't send anyone to hell, people do it to themselves. But sometimes people don't recognize just what a gift our call to live with God really is. If we look at the opposite, life without God, even in this world, is a hellish existence. So during this day of remembrance of Jesus' ascension, we think about our own call to be holy, to take it seriously, to live each day, with hope. Hope doesn't mean wishful thinking. It means, yes, I'm called to live with God, not based on my own merits, but because of His graces. I trust Him. I will not despair. I will not presume. I will do what I need to do to live as a citizen of heaven in this world. And the light of the Lord to shine through me to others. Maybe He'll be catching it.
Ascended into heaven, angels reminded his disciples that he would come back again. Until he comes, we continue his work by praying for all peoples and their needs.
That the church on earth will ever keep its evangelical mission of making disciples of all nations, we pray to the Lord. That the leaders of the world may realize that they must give an account of their work to Jesus Christ when he returns as our judge, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That no one will be so attached to this earth as to regret being called to eternal life in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that we may all come to the maturity of faith in the fullness of the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the U.S. Supreme Court will recognize marriage as an exclusive union between a man and a woman, and not legalize any redefinition that would corrupt what God has designed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who are ill, especially Rosemary Raymond, George Donnelly, Betty Dingle, Catherine Barish, Sister Maureen Spillane, Jerry Berta, and Janice Darby, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for those who have died, especially Charlene Helmick, Jean Riffle, Elizabeth Omerza, and the members of the Toth family for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father in heaven, whose Son is now seated at your right hand and enthroned in eternal glory, we make our petitions through him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please open your missalettes to number 336.
Oh,
may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
When we eat there.
render us to our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that, with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Spouse, with the blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you. before Mass is ended, the bishop has asked that all the parishes have a final Catholic Charities pledge commitment. Now, many of you have already done this, so we're not asking anybody to do something again. But if anyone has not had the opportunity to make a pledge to Catholic Charities, the bishop is asking for that to take place now. So in the pews are envelopes, and you can pass them down. There might be somebody in the pew, maybe not, but there could be one or two who have already made a pledge. Fill out the inside flap, information, put it in the envelope. All that's asked for is a pledge, if you're able to do it. And then bring the envelope with you, and one of the ushers will collect the envelope from you as you exit Mass. Thank you ahead of time to everybody who has contributed and made a pledge, and for those of you who will be doing it on behalf of the bishop. Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle in our hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps to the place where, for our sake, he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Tomorrow, the Knights of Columbus have their monthly pancake breakfast at their lodge in Geneva on Route 20 from 8 to 1. And we will have Eucharistic prayer and praise on Monday at 7 p.m. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Please open your gather hymnals to number 453.